Guitar done.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to our fourth annual Rehabilitation Variety Show, a tribute to Judith Baez. My name is Stuart Rogers, and I am your co-host along with Chip Marchbanks, the main man. And tonight, we have the confirmation of the fact that many people have accused Chip and I of conducting a dog and pony show. And so consequently, this evening, in the truest spirit of the show, my partner, Chip Marchbanks, is going to sing a song for you in a most rare fashion. Chip Marchbanks.
Come on, Joe. Come on, buddy. Come on, get on out here. Oh, boy. Oh, buddy. You know, about a year ago, there was a movie that came out that I'm sure you're all familiar with, and it was a Western about city slickers. And in that particular movie, there was a line that probably was the most important part of that whole show, and that was the fact that one of the people in the show decided to say the most important thing in life is one thing. And it ended up that you had to find that for yourself, whatever that was. And I think for you to know tonight that Judith has found that one thing, and unfortunately for us, it isn't at Golden West College anymore, but it is her family. And that's probably the one thing that none of us could argue about, the fact that she wants to be with her family. So, Judith, we want you to know that tonight the show is from us to you. Oh, boy. Whoa, Joe. Get rid of this. As I was walking by the shore, I happened there to see a woman's form lying there, as still could be. The dress she wore was gingham blue, her hair all tumbled down. It might have been my own true love, my sweetheart Jenny Brown. Her face was turned into the sand, 'twas who I could not tell. But on her hand a high school ring, a ring I knew too well. I grasped her arm, my heart stood still, and then I turned around. Oh, alas, it was my own true love, my sweetheart Jenny Brown. Oh, Jenny Brown, why did I treat you cruel? Gosh whiz, Jenny, there was tears in your eyes as you ran away from me, and now here I find you on the beach. You're all still and sandy, flies and stuff all over you. I stared into her lovely face, a face that used to clown. I saw one eye a flicker, then wink and open round. Ha ha, she laughed and jumped up tall. I bet you thought I'd drown. What a rotten sense of humor has my sweetheart Jenny Brown. Thank you. Come on, boy.
I'm glad that yeah, I don't even have to say it, do I? So I won't. All right. the Rehabilitation Center has grown under Chip's guidance, and I have had a very intimate relationship with them this last year and have become all the more grateful for their services. Another one of the major contributors to the reputation of this campus emanates from an exceptional group of people, the Disabled Students Service Center itself, but they also, in that these ladies and gentlemen engage in sign language. For those of you who might have not had the experience before to see group sign, sign itself is distinctly another tongue, a foreign language. And the way they do it, they make the foreign language into such an artistic art form. It's always my pleasure to introduce one of our most popular acts of the last 4 years, the Disabled Student Service Sign Ensemble, their first number for this evening, Summer Nights from Greece. For those of you who are familiar with the faculty and staff with the Disabled Students Center, you noticed a couple of unfamiliar faces in there, Richard Porter and Mark Craig, whom I think deserve a special round of applause for their own participation. Well, we're in the 90s, and as I tell my students, you guys missed the 30s and you missed the 60s, but you're going to get them both in the 90s. So consequently, that seems to be what's happening about now. We have with us, coincidentally, one of the delightful relics, not only of the 60s, but of the essence of the 60s, the Haight-Ashbury San Francisco circuit. Bob Angus used to sing up there in coffee shops during that particular time. Therefore, naturally, this was a prerequisite for becoming a philosopher. So consequently, tonight he's going to share some of the reminiscences with us, Bob Angus.
That's Joni Mitchell in the right place. I think you'll recognize this. Bravos and flows of angel hair, ice cream castles in the air, and feather canyons everywhere. I've looked at clouds that way, but now they only block the sun. They rain and snow on everyone. So many things I would have clouds, illusions I recall. I really don't know clouds at all. Abus and Junes and Ferris wheels, the dizzy dancing way you feel when every fairy tale comes real. I have looked at love that way, but now it's just another show. You leave them laughing when you go, and if you care, don't let them know. No, don't give yourself away. Now I've looked at love from both sides now, win and lose, and still somehow it's love's illusions I recall. I really don't. Circus crowds, I've looked at life that way, but now all friends are acting strange. They shake their heads, they say I've changed. Something's lost and something's gained in living every day. Now I've looked at life from both sides now, win and lose, and still somehow it's life's illusions I recall. I really don't know life at all.
Thank you very much. Being that besides the benefit concert that this is, of course, we're also honoring Judith Viez. And when I was thinking about what to play, I thought, well, two things come to mind with Judith. One is style, great style, but importantly also substance. And that substance is really at the heart of, I think, what we conceive to be education. And the multicultural experience is, in fact, a very broadening thing. And for those of us who have had them, most of us have, we live in Southern California. I did too. I grew up in Connecticut, and of course, we had New York and New Jersey, so that was my multicultural experience. But two things happened in terms of that multicultural theme that I wanted to do for Judith. And one of them is rather humorous, and the other one is more poignant. And last year, I sang in French just to show that I'm not simply a country boy from Connecticut. And I've got a song for you in German, and written by Pete Seeger and by Bob Dylan. And this came about when I was going to a conference at University of Heidelberg, and I stopped in Berlin. Kennedy was there. And the kind of funny part is, when you're dealing with another language, it is very easy to make the wrong kind of mistake. And I don't know if you recall, this was, as I was reminded by an historian friend of mine the other day, not 20 years ago, but 30 years ago, and Kennedy was visiting Berlin. And he was very popular there, and that's just after the wall had gone up. And he wanted to show his support for West Germany, and he did this. He wanted to say, "I'm a Berliner," and he did it in German. Now, that's, he said, "Ich bin ein Berliner." That is equivalent to what we know in English as the difference between "I'm a Dane" and "I'm a Danish." In other words, he announced that he was a Berliner, which is really a jelly donut. It didn't really matter, because they loved him anyway. That's the funny one, Judith. The poignant one is, in this same trip, I was traveling in eastern Germany, and I happened to be at the Russian War Memorial. So much going on in the world, these things come to mind. And remember, this is very, very bad time. And there were two singers at the Russian War Memorial in the eastern zone, singing American songs in German, both of which were very popular at the time. And I'd like to kind of put them together here so as not to be out here all night. But in the spirit of the multicultural, I would dedicate this to Judith. And as I said, it's partly in English and partly in German. You're, I'm sure, very familiar with both songs. I'm never sure whether I'm singing in English or German anyway, So if I do two verses in German in a row, somebody raise his or her hand and say English, please. You'll recognize this.
Sagt mir, wo die Blumen sind, wo sind sie geblieben? Sagt mir, wo die Blumen sind, was ist geschehen? Sagt mir, wo die Blumen sind, Mädchen, fluchten sie geschwind. Wann wird man je verstehen? Oh, when will they ever learn? Where have all the flowers gone? Long time passing. Where have all the flowers gone? Long time ago. Where have all the flowers gone? Gone for soldiers, everyone. Oh, when will they ever learn? Wann wird man je verstehen? Und sagt, wo die Soldaten sind, wo sind sie geblieben? Where have all the soldiers gone? Long time ago. Where have all the soldiers gone? Gone to graveyards, everyone. Wann wird man je verstehen? Wann wird man je verstehen? How many roads must a man walk down before you call him a man? Yes, and how many seas must the white dove sail before she sleeps in the sand? And how many times must the cannonballs fly before they're forever banned? Oh, die Antwort, mein Freund, is waiting in der Wind. Die Antwort is waiting in der Wind. And how many years can a mountain exist before it's washed to the sea? And how many years can some people exist before they're allowed to be free? And how many times can a man turn his head, pretending he just doesn't see? Oh, the answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The Antwort is waiting in der Wind.
Adios, Judith.
Our next act is traditionally, again, one of the most popular of the evening. Last year, they were not able to perform because of separate obligations. The entire family is in demand. They have won numerous awards, trophies, acknowledgments all over the world, literally all over the world, from Scotland to the United States. So we have the Stratton Family Dancers with Gary and his lovely wife, Roz, and their ever-beautying daughter, Meg, who will do the encore after the family does their first number, the Stratton Family Dancers.
Thank you.
I want you to know, for people who were here last year, you'll see there's a lot of little pieces of tape down here that shine in the dark. That's because last year I fell off into there. And so I personally put all this tape down last night. Also, there's tape underneath the curtain here because I got hit in the head with the drape or the curtain one time too. So I personally did that myself. Many of our performers have gotten their start either here at Golden West College or at our sister school, Orange Coast College. And the next group is one of those particular groups that got their roots from here. Pamela Bell is an instructor, or was an instructor, of a choral class over at Orange Coast College at one time. Also, at the close of the show last year, I got a call the very next day from one of our illustrious district staff members, and that's used to be Sandy Thomas, now Sandy Thornton. And she is a member of this group, and so pleased to present to you the Harbor Singers.
Spreading the news, I'm leaving today.
Don't they have a wonderful sound? And the sentiment could not be expressed more appropriately. Our heart does belong to Judith, and oh, are we going to miss Our Lady very, very much. The next act is another one of the instances that Chip was speaking of relative to a student who has studied here in the district, either at OCC or Coastline or Golden West College. In this particular instance, you have a teacher who has studied another art form here. Jane Smith has been studying under Henrietta Carter, and I've had the pleasure to work with Jane for, about 3 years now. So I have seen her evolve from year to year to year with this glorious instrument that she has. And she is sounding literally professional now, and it's such a delight to hear her. So tonight we will be regaled with Jane in an aria from Puccini, and her accompanist is Cindy Ward, Jane Smith.
Germoglio.
I don't know about you, but every time I hear something like that, I have a desire to go home and watch Godfather, have some Chianti, and have some pasta. I can't help it. I love it. Why wasn't I Italian, God? You know? Okay, thank you very much, Gene. That was beautiful. Our next act tonight is a classical pianist who has, again, performed here. But this is a special event tonight for Bill Hyde, who is going to do a couple of pieces from Chopin. But tonight, his mother is in the audience, and so I would like to welcome, on behalf of us here at the college and in the theater, Mrs. Hyde. Thank you. Welcome to California. And your son will do you proud, Bill Hyde.
Pieces are by Rachmaninoff.
Thank you.
This might be an appropriate time to mention the fact that the show is being taped this evening by Warren Carter's students, so the tape should be available. And I was thinking that they have the old Ed Sullivan Show tapes available now again. And why go out and buy an old Ed Sullivan when you can buy a new Rehabilitation Show tape, right? Because, I mean, this is really our big show. Our next act is, again, one of the singers we're very, very proud of relative to the fact that we have so many of the students who are performing here who have trained here and at OCC. Now, Bob Brigg is one student.
Daddy didn't like me none, but I love your grandma so. We had this crazy plan to meet and run away. Between now and then, till I see you again, I'll be loving you. Love me. I read those words just hours before my grandma passed away. In a doorway of a church,
you guys having a good time? Well, that's good. I'm glad to hear. Judith, I hope you're having a good time tonight. That's good to hear. Well, it's tradition time. We're about to see the reason that this show is held every year. We're about to bring out the Rehabilitation Fitness people to do their doodah chair aerobic exercises for you. The group is led by Bruce Heckman, who's the instructor and director of the program. And we have a number of the students been practicing for a few weeks for this. They're a little bit antsy about this because they're not used to getting up in front of people, but we're ready to bring them on for you, and here they are, the Doodah Marchers.
Okay. prepare your cards. Good evening. This is our small tribute to our good friend, Judith Valliez. Please join us after the show at the reception. Now, let's get into some real aerobic work. Where was our president born? Cards number one. Up. Cards down. Where did our president spend her childhood? Cards number two. Up. Cards down. Where did our president attend college? Cards number three. Up. Cards down. Where did she attend graduate school? Cards number four. Up. Cards down. She had a fantasy to attend this university. Cards number five. Up. And cards down. Where has she spent the last 4 years? Cards number six, up. Hey! Cards down. Let's give our president a doodah marcher's wave into retirement. Hey, Judah!
Thank you, Bruce and the Doodahs. Bruce Heckman is also a Lieutenant Colonel Bruce Heckman, and he was called to duty during the crisis over in the desert. Fortunately, Bruce was in Texas and not over in the Gulf. God knows what would have happened had the Iraqis come face to face with Bruce. Before we have our next number, I'd like to make a few acknowledgments tonight for the people who have done the technical work and who have done the secretarial work, et cetera, for the show. First of all, I'd like to thank our secretaries in the fine arts, Eddie Frain and Pat Stengel, who have done marvelous jobs for us. Talk about two invaluable ladies who are deeply appreciated but rarely acknowledged. We all are deeply indebted to both of them and also love them dearly. Also, our technical staff here is one of the best. I've had the pleasure of working with these gentlemen for 15, in some instances, 20 years. We have Mark Craig, who has not only been selected Employee of the Month and was one of the candidates for the Employee of the Year, Noreen, who runs the box office, who is here. They're ubiquitous. They give of their own time with all of the things that we do. Dave Falzone and Chuck Davis make this place work. And they do this on their own, folks. This is not part of their contract. When we have the rehearsals and they're here, they close up every single night and are here, and they make the thing look as smoothly as it does simply because of their expertise. So we are very indebted to them. Now, our next act is a delightful change of pace for you. It's a duet. It's a love ballad between two senior citizens who happen to meet each other in a park and have a very brief exchange in the park while the lady is sitting at the park bench reading her book. It's called Too Late for Happiness from Neil Simon's play, The Good Doctor, with Yetta Benson and Michael O'Meara. Too Late for Happiness.
It seems to be clouding up a bit.
Yes, I'm beginning to feel a chill in the air.
Oh, would you like my scarf for your neck?
Thank you, no. It's getting late. I must be getting home.
Oh, yes, I was thinking that same thing. That very same thing, yes. Unless you'd care to join me for a cup of tea. A cup of hot tea, yes. That might be just the very thing.
Not today.
I'm sure you didn't recognize Michael, who was also the gentleman who had some television coverage and some coverage, at least in the Los Angeles Times. He was the one who was unemployed, out looking for a job, and he had the sign, "Will work for five figures." Our final act of the first part of the show, there will be a 10-minute intermission following this act. The last act, then, of the the last performance of the first act is a reprise of one of the acts from Carol Coniglia's recent, very successful dance show. It is choreographed by the dancer, and it is called "Turn Up the Heat."
Never knew how much I love you. Never knew how much I care. When you put your arms around me, I get a fever that's so hard to bear. Even a fever when you kiss me, fever when you hold me tight, fever in the morning, fever all through the night. Sun lights up the daytime, moon lights up the night. I light up when you call my name, and you know I'm gonna treat you right. You hear me, fever. When you kiss me, fever when you hold me tight, fever in the morning, fever all through the night. Everybody's got the fever. That is something you all know. Fever isn't such a new thing. Fever started long ago. Romeo loved Juliet. Juliet, she felt the same. When he put his arms around her, he said, "Julie, baby, you're my flame." Now give us fever when we kisses, fever with thy flame. Fever, I'm on fire, fever, yeah, I burn forsooth. Captain Smith and Pocahontas had a very mad affair. When her daddy tried to kill him, she said, "Daddy, oh, don't you dare give me fever. With his kisses, fever, when he holds me tight. Fever, I'm his missus, Daddy, won't you treat him right?" Now you listen to my story. Here's the point that I've made. Cats were born to give chicks fever, be it Fahrenheit or centigrade. We give you fever when we kiss you, fever if you live and learn. Fever till you sizzle. But what a lovely way to burn. What a lovely way to burn. What a lovely way to burn. What a lovely way to burn.
Okay. Well, I personally would like to make a couple of acknowledgments tonight, too. One of them is that after the first year of the show, and it was a lot of work, and Stu and I really appreciated it, but we had given some thought to, well, that was a lot of fun. Maybe we should let it die when it was a success. And there was a lady here on campus, our school president, who brought me into her office and said, "Chip, you've started a tradition that we think is really, really neat, and so we'd really like to see you continue it." So Judith is one of the people that I'd like to acknowledge for this show staying in existence. Probably most important, though, is that when I came up with the idea for the show, there was a man that if we didn't get him involved, there was no way that it was ever going to occur. And unfortunately, earlier this year, or actually the end of last year, he had an extremely unfortunate accident. If you thought he was limping just because he felt sorry for me, that's not the particular case. He is limping because he fell off of a 35-foot cliff, destroyed his ankle, had numerous surgeries, I believe it was 8, to correct for the bones and also for skin grafts. And it's a miracle that he lived after this amazing fall that he took, and to me it's a miracle that he would volunteer to be here again tonight when he can have difficulties, or when he has such difficulties just trying to move around. But I really would like you to give a warm, warm welcome to the man that makes this show work, and that's Stu Rogers. Thanks, bud.
No, stay. I promised them our Ginger Rogers Fred Astaire number.
That's right.
For the second. Right. Thank you, Chip. Okay, our first number, thank you very much. Our first number for the second act is again a favorite. We have one of the people who I believe was one of the charter students and charter employees of the district from the very, very inception, and she has been associated with the college ever since. Gloria Petrona, we all know Gloria. And she, in her retirement, there's no such thing as retirement for Gloria. She has been the initiator, the founder, and the driving force behind a group of, they don't want to be called senior citizens at all. They are identified as Westminster swingers rather than seniors. And as I understand, they are officially known as the goodwill ambassadors of Westminster. So I give you Gloria Petrona and the Westminster Swingers.
A couple of oldies. One is called Sweet Adeline, the other one is called Let Me Call You Sweetheart. So we've got to keep America singing, and that means you've got to be joining us in the singing. Now here's a chance for some of you to do some harmonizing and to do your own thing. This is legal now, you can get away with it. Any sound that comes out of you is official, it's okay. All right, we're going to sing with a tape and we're going to have a good time here. And this is for you, Judith. All right, here we go.
Sweet Adeline, sweet Adeline, my Adeline, my Adeline, at thy dear heart, at thy dear
look okay? Yeah. Okay, sir.
All right, everybody, gather around. The candy man is here. Now, what kind of candy do you want? Sweet chocolate, chocolate malt, candy, gumdrops, anything you want. You've come to the right man because I'm the candy man.
Who can take a sunrise?
Can't you just hear Lawrence Welk up there saying, wonderful, wonderful? All right. Our next act, again, is one of the gentlemen who has performed and has performed in the Master Chorale and was in Evita. One of the students that I was speaking of who is not only participating in the show but has paid his dues by performing in a number of other district activities as well. The gentleman's name is John Moran. His song is Let Love Stay, and he will be accompanied by Judy Weaver, John Moran.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to do a Dan Fogelberg tune for you, a very pretty one, which you probably will remember, Make Love Stay. Thank you.
love. Now that the lonely nights are over, how do we make love stay? Now that we know the fire can burn bright or merely smolder, how do we keep it from dying away? Elusive as dreams, barely remembered in the morning, love like a phantom. It pales like an empty smile adoring a statue of sightless eyes. Moments sweet, they taste so sweet within the rapture. Precious flesh is greedily consumed. Ooh, that mystery is a thing not so easily captured. And once deceased, not easily exhumed. That we love. Now that those lonely nights are over, how do we make love stay? Moments fleet, they taste oh so sweet within the rapture. Precious flesh is greedily consumed. That mystery is a thing not so easily captured. And once deceased, not easily exhumed. That we love. Look at the moonless night and tell me, how do we make love stay?
Thank you. You've been a great audience. Let's have a round of applause for Judy Weaver. She did a great job on that song.
Our next soloist is also a member of the cast of Vita, and one of the young women who performed at the 100th anniversary at Carnegie Hall. Melanie Vanek is going to sing Omino Bambino Caro, also from Puccini, and her accompanist is David Lewis. Melanie?
My name is Melanie Vanek. I would like to tell you a little bit about the song, exactly what it means. It comes from a one-act play by Puccini, and the name of the play, the opera, I should say, is Gianni Ticci. And the part that I'm singing is Loretta, the daughter of Gianni Ticci, and she is pleading with her dying father. to allow her to marry, to get the permission to marry a man that she does not care for. And she's saying that she is going to get some wedding rings, and she is going into town to buy these rings, and she hopes it's not all in vain. But if it is, she's going to toss herself in the Arno River, and she's telling God that she would really like to die. So she begs for his mercy, and hopefully he'll give it to her. Thank you.
Thank you, Melanie. Our next act is someone who we're very, very familiar with in a number of capacities. I won't go on and on and on because I can bore you to death about this lady. I think I've known her for a lot more years than she would care to admit. Dolores Harper is going to dance the Hawaiian wedding song, and she is dedicating it to Judith and Harry, relative to their mutually enjoying their retirement now, and they're planning the next phase of their marriage together, and we hope a most romantic fashion, which she is going to epitomize in her dance. Dolores Harper.
You longer than forever. like me never. Here I'm now, dear. For my love I vow, dear. Promise me that you will leave me never. I will love you longer than forever.
Judith, this is your marriage bouquet. We won't toss it to you, but if you'll please come forward, Dolores will hand it to you. This arrangement was handmade with love by Cheryl and Candy in Community Services, and they made it especially for you.
Hello up there. Okay. Our next performer is a speech instructor here at Golden West College, and she is also a dynamite vocalist. I heard her for the first time the other night. Her name is Dolores also, Dolores Curry, and she is going to give a gangbusters rendition of One Moment in Time. Dolores Curry.
Thank you.
For our second Golden West College dance program number tonight, we have another very, very popular.
I tell you, I sure wish I could dance like that. You know, one time, many years ago, I was at an establishment with some friends of mine, and they were playing music, and people were dancing, and I wasn't married at the time, and people kept coming over, girls kept coming over and asking me to dance, and I said, I'm sorry, I don't dance. And I had a few toddies, and a little while later, a girl finally came over and convinced me that I should get up and dance. I got up and danced, and they started playing a German polka. And there, she was throwing me all over the room, and I mean to tell you, that was the last time I danced, and my wife will attest to that. So, okay. Well, she can't attest to actually that was before we were married, but since we've been married. Okay. The next act that we have is a student here from Golden West College. His name is Dennis Cole, and he performs in both the Golden West and Orange Coast College chorales. And he's going to sing for us tonight and accompany himself on the guitar. And he's going to sing a song called Let Him In.
Hey, how you guys doing? I was trying to pick a song tonight to sing about, and I couldn't think of a better subject to sing about than Jesus Christ. You've been searching so long in so many places, on so many faces, to find a peace that you lack. When you think you will find it, it evades your grasp. You've been living so long for yourself. You keep putting the Lord on a shelf. As he stands at your heart and he knocks on the door, you'll never find a peace that you've been looking for. Until you let Jesus come inside, and in your heart abide, he wants to give his love to you. There's only one thing left to do. He wants to cleanse your soul. He wants complete control. He's waiting for you to let him in. Let him in, let him in. Deep inside of your soul, you know that you need him, and still you refuse him. Yes, Jesus is the right choice. But you're too busy playing to even hear his voice. But now there is no time for delay, because he could come back any day. You know each one will stand before God on that day. Give your life to Jesus, he's just a prayer away. And let Jesus come inside, and in your heart abide, he wants to give his love to you. There's only one thing left to do, he wants to cleanse your soul. He wants complete control. He's waiting for you to let him in. Let him in. Let him in. You've got to let him in. Let him in.
Thank you. Praise God. God bless you guys.
Kill it.